ಅಯಂ ಹಿ ರೋಹಿಣಿ ಪುತ್ರೋ ರಮಯನ್ ಸುಹೃದೋ ಗುಣೈ ಆಖ್ಯಾಸ್ಯತೆ ರಾಮ ಇತಿ ಬಲಾಧಿಕ್ಯಾತ್ ಬಲಂ ವಿದುಹು ಯದೂನಾಂ ಅಪೃಥಕ್ ಭಾವಾತ್ ಸಂಕರ್ಷಣಂ ಉಷಂತ್ಯಪಿ. ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಡಿಕ್ಲೇರ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದೇವಕಿ, ಸೆವೆನ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದೇವಕಿ, ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ಆಸ್ ಸನ್ ಆಫ್ ರೋಹಿಣಿ, ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ನೋನ್ ಬೈ ತ್ರೀ ನೇಮ್ಸ್, ಸಂಕರ್ಷಣ, ರಾಮ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಲಭದ್ರ. Three names. That's the verse we read. Now here, Gargamuni is going to give name-giving ceremony. What is he telling? He is telling, this child, the son of Rohini, will give all happiness to his relatives and friends by his transcendental qualities. Therefore, he will be known as Rama. The first name he gives is Rama. And because he will manifest extraordinarily bodily strength, he will also be known as Bala. Second name is Bala. Moreover, because he unites two families, Vasudeva's family and the family of Nanda Maharaj, he'll be known as Sankarshana. What is happening with Balaram? He is born as a son of Rohini, who is one of the queens of Vasudeva. But Rohini has taken shelter of Nanda Maharaj. Therefore, Nanda Maharaj is known as the foster father of Balaram. Correct? Therefore, he will unite the two families of Vasudeva and Nanda Maharaj. Therefore, he'll be known as Sankarshana. Three names: Rama, Bala, and Sankarshana. So, therefore, again, the name Bala is sometimes known as Balabhadra, sometimes known as Baladeva, sometimes known as Balarama. And throughout the Bhagavatam, Balaram is known as Rama, sometimes known as Rama, sometimes known as Balarama, sometimes known as Balabhadra, sometimes known as Sankarshana, sometimes known as Ananta, sometimes known as Shesha. Because actually Balaram, the truth about Balaram is, he is the first plenary expansion of Krishna in the spiritual world. He is the immediate expansion. And he always assists Krishna in his pastimes, both in the spiritual world and the material world. In the spiritual world, he is assisting Krishna in his pastimes in Goloka Vrindavana as Balaram. Krishna and Balaram in the spiritual world, Golok Vrindavana, are always together performing all kinds of pastimes as small children, cowherd boys. That is the position of Balaram. So that is described elaborately in the 10th canto. All the pastimes of Krishna, you see, along with him, Balaram is there. Balaram is there in Krishna's, along with Krishna's pastimes, many of the pastimes. Then, when Krishna appears in this material world as in his original form as Krishna, Balaram also appears in his original form as Balaram. Then, when Krishna appears as Rama, Balaram appears as Lakshmana. Krishna appears as Mahavishnu, Balaram appears as Sheshanag. Whichever Vishnu form Krishna appears, Balaram appears as Shesha. And then when Krishna appears as so many different incarnations, always Balaram also appears with Krishna. So Balaram actually is the constant companion of Krishna in all his pastimes. So when Krishna appeared as Chaitanya, Balaram appeared as Nityananda, again, constant accompanying companion of Krishna. Chaitanya and Nityananda performed pastimes together, especially the Sankirtan pastimes. Chaitanya and Nityananda together they performed. So, Balaram is actually the first expansion of Krishna. And Balaram further expands into so many forms. The Vishnu forms, the form of Anantasesha, the form of Sheshanag, all the paraphernalia of Krishna is actually Balaram. It's Balaram's expansion. The seat on which Krishna sits, the throne, is actually expansion of Balaram. The footwear which Krishna wears is expansion of Balaram. Anantasesha, on whom Vasudeva or Mahavishnu is lying, that is also expansion of Balaram. Sheshnag, Sheshatalpa, the bedstead of Krishna is Shesha, who is expansion of Balaram. So Balaram serves Krishna in so many ways. But Balaram also independently performs some pastimes. For example, in the Krishna book it is described, Balaram went to visit the inhabitants of Vrindavan after Krishna and Balaram came away to Mathura, being brought by Krura. Then Balaram once paid a visit to Vrindavan to pacify the residents of Vrindavan. They were feeling separation from Krishna and Balaram. So to pacify them, Balaram once went. So there in Vrindavan, he was in the house of Nanda and Yashoda. And they were very happy. Nanda and Yashoda were very happy to receive Balaram. So then Balaram performed rasa dance along with some of the gopis. Balaram performed rasa dance. So it is revealed that Balaram also has his independent pastimes along with his associates. Like that, even Nityananda, he has his pastimes with his associates also. Nityananda performs his pastimes, Sankirtan pastimes. That's described in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. So Balaram has his independent pastimes also. One particular demon Balaram killed, Dvivida. He was a friend of Kamsa, associate of Kamsa. So this Dvivida was also terrorizing innocent people, saintly persons. So some saintly persons complained to Balaram that the Dvivida is creating so much of nuisance. He's not allowing us to do our yajnas and all our spiritual activities. So Balaram decided to kill this Dvivida. And Balaram actually single-handedly killed this Dvivida. Then in the Krishna book, there is a description. Balaram killed some of the demons sent by Kamsa when Krishna and Balaram were playing the part of cowherd boys in Vrindavan. So one Dhenukasura, one demon, Dhenukasura, in the shape of one donkey, ass, demon, he was in Talavan. And the Talavan was inhabited by this Dhenukasura along with many of his associates. So people could not go to this Talavan forest because full of tal trees, there were beautiful tal fruits. Tal fruits are very, very sweet, very juicy. So when the season comes for the tal fruit, so many tal fruits in the tal trees, they will appear and they'll fall down. One type of palm tree, tal tree is one type of palm tree actually. This tal fruit is only seen in Vrindavan. It is not there in other places. In South India also, they have this palm tree which gives one type of fruit, correct? They eat that fruit. It is looks like coconut tree, but it's not a coconut tree, tal tree. So this it looks like a palm tree also. It is not even a palm tree. It's a different species. So that tal fruit, when it was ripe and so many tal fruits had fallen, nobody could go inside because of this presence of this Dhenukasura and his associates. The friends of Krishna and Balaram, they complained to Krishna and Balaram that these demons, they are blocking our way and people are also afraid to go. So we want to eat those tal fruits. So kindly let us go, and if they create any disturbance, kindly kill them. So because they had seen Krishna and Balaram had killed so many demons earlier, right? Who had came to disturb the pastimes of the cowherd boys with Krishna. So they went to the Talwan forest. Immediately Dhenukasura became very much agitated. Who is dare come inside this forest when I am the lord of this forest? Like that he was thinking. So immediately he saw Krishna, Balaram and the cowherd boys. Then they began to attack. Immediately Balaram took hold of this Dhenukasura and simply by wheeling him, got hold of this demon by in the form of an ass by his hind legs. This ass has got a habit of kicking people when there is danger by kicking from the hind legs, the legs behind. So Balaram caught hold of this hind legs and simply wheeled that demon and threw him into the forest. So the demon lost his life midair and then fell down dead. Then all the other associates of Dhenukasura came to attack Krishna and Balaram. And Krishna and Balaram together, they kept on killing all the other associates of this Dhenukasura. So this Dhenukasura was killed specifically by Balaram. Another demon, Prabhupada, he was also specifically killed by Balaram. Generally, either Krishna or Balaram will kill these demons sent by Kamsa to Vrindavan, but some specific demons were killed by Balaram. So Balaram is known as Balaram because of his extraordinary strength. Extraordinary strength he did display. Extraordinary strength. Bala, Bhadra, Balaram or Baladev. So he's also, Balaram is also the original spiritual master of everyone. Because by his blessings, one can get transcendental knowledge. Transcendental knowledge is obtained by the blessings of Balaram. So, Balaram is considered Adi Guru. So, one should pray to Balaram for all kinds of protection because he is extraordinarily strong. Because he is the original spiritual master, one should pray to Balaram for transcendental knowledge. And one should pray to Balaram for also the highest spiritual bliss called Ramana. By Balaram's mercy, one can be blessed with this highest spiritual bliss called Ramana. So all these reasons, one should worship Balaram, pray to Balaram. Today is his appearance day. So we are celebrating this appearance day in order to get the blessings of Balaram, to glorify him. There are so many glories of Balaram declared in the scriptures. Many, many scriptures declare the glories of Balaram. Even the Bhagavatam, where Krishna glorifies Balaram. Krishna glorifies Balaram. There is a incident like that described in the Bhagavatam. So Balaram's glories are there, declared in all the scriptures and even in the Bhagavatam also. 10th canto especially, Balaram's glories are declared. So simply by hearing, remembering, chanting the name, form, activities, the deity of Balaram, just by having darshan, evening we're going to have Abhishek for Krishna Balaram deity. Balaram here. So we're going to have Abhishek. So participating in this Abhishek, partaking the Charanamrit, the water that has washed the deity form of Balaram. So all these ways we can awaken our Krishna consciousness very easily. We can become fixed up in our devotional service by the blessings of Balaram because he is the original spiritual master. So our spiritual master Prabhupada is the representative of Balaram. Is the representative of Balaram. All spiritual masters are considered representatives of Balaram. Because Balaram is the original spiritual master who gives, spiritual master is specially meant for giving us transcendental knowledge. So Balaram is the one who is the original personality who awards transcendental knowledge for somebody who wants to become spiritually enlightened. Simply by reading books, you cannot become spiritually enlightened. You may have some theoretical knowledge, but for that knowledge to become realization, you require enlightenment by the Supreme Lord. So especially the Supreme Lord in his form as Balaram enlightens those who are fortunate, who are blessed by giving them transcendental knowledge. So Balaram is the one who gives us transcendental knowledge. So we should pray to Balaram for transcendental knowledge, for transcendental bliss called Ramana, and for protection. Balaram especially protects the devotees from all kinds of dangers because he is extraordinarily got extraordinary strength. That's why he's called Balaram or Balabhadra, Baladeva, Bala. Transcendental strength. It's not material strength. It is transcendental strength by which Balaram protects all the devotees.
Hare Krishna. Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any updates.